Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Jennifer Day Live at Night. It's another glorious Monday. And tonight we are talking binge-worthy television. Yay. So give me a call and let's talk about it. I'm excited. So as always, I will start the show with a fun little song. So here we go. Change the land. So close your eyes and take me by the hand. At times I know when things are meant to be. Not so sure what that means for you and me.
You make me feel like playing all night long. Kissing and hugging and vibing all night long. You make me feel like playing all night long. Wrapped in your arms so warm.
Are only in my mind. My dreams are vivid and full of you every time. This could never be reality. Life ain't gonna be that easy. What is what brought us together? Play is no option, we know better. My alarm is ringing me awake. Only in my sleep did I make a mistake. Binge-worthy television. What are you watching? I'll tell you mine if you tell me yours. Hello, you're on Live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Hey, hey Jennifer, see, so hear me? I'm watching you on my tablet because I hope I'm not too loud because I'm trying to my computer. So what's the topic
tonight?
Yeah,
I can hear you well. So you're getting all techie with your tablet. That's cool. So tonight we are talking about television that you are watching and binge watching. Like, you know how there's Netflix and Hulu and all of that? So people will just sit there and watch the next episode and the next episode. So what TV show are you watching right now that you're really excited about that you don't want to stop watching?
Hey, listen. I was gonna tell you. I know that song is called It's called Just One Night. That's the name of the song.
Yes. Oh, I'm so glad you like that song. Yeah, I haven't gotten a chance to do that one live yet, so I'm going to put that on my list of things to do, songs to do for Cecil.
Yeah, I was thinking, because I turn my volume down on my tablet. Maybe one of these days I send an email. One of these days maybe you can make the song live. Maybe you can make it like a 12-inch mix someday, you know?
Yes, absolutely. Well, you keep writing down your favorite songs, and as you think of them, tell me, and then I'll make sure that I get them in the show at some points here in the future.
Yeah.
So that's a good one.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I was watching these movies I got from the library, The Intern with Annie Hathaway and the actor, what's his name, Robert De Niro, about he plays the intern. Yeah, that was a good movie, too.
Right. Oh, that's good. That's a good one, yes.
Yeah.
So, well, you have to tell me about some TV shows you've been watching. Do you watch Netflix or any of that?
Well, no, not really, because, see, I don't have cable.
Oh, gotcha. So you're more of a movie person. But, you know, they have a bunch of stuff on YouTube, too, these days. Like, there's a lot of TV shows that people actually watch on YouTube.
Yeah.
So people are getting into all kinds of stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
So lately, I've been watching a bunch of HBO shows, but there's one that's called Veep, V-E-E-P, with Julia Louis-Dreyfus, and she was from Seinfeld. And she plays the vice president. And oh my gosh, it's hilarious. So I've been watching it since the beginning. I think they're in their like fifth season right now. But it is so good. Like, it's a little bit like, oh my God, I can't believe they just said that on TV. Like outrageous, but like super funny. And her comedy timing is brilliant. And I actually got to meet her. There was a FYC event that my agent took me to here in LA for Veep.
Yeah.
So what they do is they have a lot of the Emmy members come and they, you know, do a Q&A and they meet and greet, and you could take pictures and hang out with the stars of the show, which is very cool. And you meet the writers and producers. So that's great for me. And then so I got a picture with her, and she was amazing. It was so much fun.
Cool. Hey, listen, I was going to tell you, Before I forget, kind of the weather, but I'm okay. But now I'm just gonna say, I did send you some stuff too. I got to kind of.
Yeah, you sent me a picture of your artwork that you did. You said you had some arts and crafts and stuff, and that was really cool. I liked it. It was a little fish, a little blue and orange fish. That was really cool. Thank you.
I made at the day prom class. We went to Sequest, you know, it's in Littleton. It's like a kind of like a aquarium like you have in San Diego, the aquarium out there, you know.
Oh, nice.
I
love aquariums. I love to see the fish and all the different kind of sea animals. And there's one in Long Beach that I've been to a couple times called the Aquarium of the Pacific.
Yeah.
So I would say check that one out. That one is really amazing. Yeah. And I actually went whale watching out there, too. So you take a ship out and you can see the whales out on the water. It's like, bring a coat.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's a little chilly, so cool.
Yeah. I know. Yeah. You know, I was going to tell you, too. I did get this cool video, too. I have it. I got it at video. It's a music, and it has all the next time I have to show you next time. I checked out the library. It has like Hawaiian music, like from the South Pacific. It's kind of interesting. You know?
I love Hawaiian music, and they do their like hula dancing and everything.
Yeah. Because I've been kind of. I'm sorry about bothering you about the submarines and then the Attack of the 50-Foot Women. I know you'll get around to that movie, because that movie, I know you haven't seen it. It's that movie. I remember that movie years ago. I mean, it's a classic. You know, it's a sci-fi thriller. You know, they made so many women about being giant women, you know, I mean, and then I put you in one of my movies, you know what I mean?
That is awesome. That's so cool. Well, thank you so much for calling me, Cecil. I'm going to try and say hi to a few more people, but I will talk to you again Monday. Have a wonderful week,
and
thank you for sending me all the pictures and stuff. I always like what you send
me. Yeah, thanks. Yeah,
all
I'm going to take care of myself. I got a little cold, but I'll see you next week. Have a good night. Bye.
Bye. Hello, you are on live with Jennifer. How's it going?
I'm good. How about you?
I'm good. Who's calling?
My name is Mike. You probably heard of me before. I'm Riot Coke.
I called in last week.
Oh, you did? Oh, well, thank you for calling back. Nice. Today we're talking binge-worthy television. So are you a Game of Thrones person, or are you a Barry is on HBO? That's a cool show. What have you watched lately?
Oh, gosh. I've been watching, like, Family Guy.
Nice.
American Dad.
You know, I watched South Park in that kind of world before.
Yeah.
It's a little out there, but I'm a fan of musical theater, and they did the Book of Mormon, the musical, and so it kind of got me into South Park. So,
it's a stoner show, so
yeah,
you have to try to understand it.
I gotcha. That's fun. I am a big fan of animated movies, though, so I have to, watch movies. Some more of the animated, like, TV shows and stuff. I used to watch, like, Ren and Stimpy. Do you remember that ridiculous show back in the day?
Yes, I'm old enough to remember Ren and Stimpy.
I was a baby, but it was, I think my parents probably didn't want me to watch it, and I kind of snuck and watched it.
Well, it was violent. If you watch it now as an adult versus when you're a kid, it was violent.
And you know what other one I remember from back in the day? Beavis and Butthead. Do you remember that show?
Yeah.
That was such a ridiculous show, but I remember that. And the guy had, like, the AC/DC shirt.
Yeah, AC/DC and Metallica.
Yeah. Oh, yes. And can you do the voices? Do one of the voices.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
Yeah.
That's hilarious. Where are you calling from? Did you tell me? I can't remember from last week.
I'm originally from California, but I moved to Oklahoma.
To where?
Oklahoma.
You guys have a famous musical after you, right? Have you heard? Oklahoma, where the wind. Da, da, da.
Well, I know, I'm such a musical theater nerd. Bethlehema, so.
Oh, my goodness. Well, be careful of that then. Stay good. Be good.
I have to plead the fifth on that one.
Okay. I just want to keep you around a little while. I'm going to keep you here. No. Keep you playing with us.
My doctor say something different, but that's okay.
Oh, goodness. So was last week the first time you actually got to see my show?
No. I've been watching the show since, like, November-ish.
Oh, nice.
I just been watching it.
Oh, okay. So you're a little
shy
before?
I got in a few different times before, and a couple of my friends have.
Oh, cool. Well, shout out to your friends, then.
One of my friends, he did the ATM thing with you.
I feel like I remember that, yes.
Yeah, it was back in December-ish.
Okay. I do remember that.
You thought the ATM was the putting your card in the machine to get money. But it was that.
Yes, he got me on that one. That was funny.
Yeah. Shout out to Deuce over there. What's up, Deuce?
Nice. Well, thank you so much for calling. I'll have to say hi to you again next Monday. But thank you for calling and for donating. I appreciate it. So if you guys want to call and say hi to me, just do a little donation. There's a link below or above the video, streamlabs.com/JenniferDayTV. And when you get the email from PayPal, it'll have the phone number listed in there, and that's how you call me, and I appreciate. So thank you for that. Hello, you're on Live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Hi there, sunshine girl.
Hey, Michael, how are you?
Well, I'm okay, except I got serious tooth problems.
Oh no, like a toothache?
Yeah, so it's going to be kind of hard to understand me.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm glad you called. And today we're talking about binge-worthy television. So are there any TV shows that you really like that you kind of just keep watching the next episode or the next episode?
Oh, sure. When I really binge on TV, usually it's sports, but not always.
Did you watch the Tiger Woods spectacular win this weekend?
No, the last time I really binged was probably March Madness.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a good one to watch, because then you just, like, are really in what's going on with the stats and where all the players are. And did you do the, what do you call it, the spreadsheet where you decide, you know, you plan ahead and decide who's going to win and then see if you're right?
Yeah, I did pretty good this year.
Nice. Okay. Do you play like fantasy with your friends so that you like play for money, or do you guys just do it for fun for yourself?
We usually do it for like a bottle of bourbon or something like that.
Nice. All right. So there's a prize at least. That's cool.
And then there's a couple of TV. There's a couple of quiz shows that I watch every day. Oh. I always watch Jeopardy, and I always watch Wheel of Fortune.
Nice. Those ones are cool because, you know, maybe you can't get every single question, but usually like two or three questions along the way, you're like, I totally know the answer to this. And then you're, you know, it makes you feel smart, which is fun. And then you kind of go back in your mind of like school and classes, and you're like, I know this answer. What is it? And then there's some that you're just like, I have no idea how that person came to that answer. Like, that's amazing because it's so out there, right?
Right.
Yeah. But there, whenever it's on in the background, I'm always like, you know, you kind of are in the middle of doing something else, but it makes you stop and like actually pay attention because it gets your brain going.
Yeah.
I like that.
I usually binge watch on an old show, The Twilight Zone.
Those are scary, though.
And then I also like Mystery Science Theater.
Ooh.
I like Matt.
Nice.
The X-Files and Modern Family.
I do like Modern Family. That's a good one. Some of the scary stuff, I have a hard time. I'm like, I'm so scared. I can't. Like, I freak out. Like on the movie set, when I'm an actor in a scary movie, I'm fine because I'm like, I'm there. I know it's fake. But as soon as I am watching something that I'm not in, it's just like on TV or a movie, I get so scared. And I'm like, I'm an actor. I should know like that this is all fake. Like, I don't understand why I get so scared, but I'm like that person in the back, like kicking their feet and screaming. I've stopped watching this too scary stuff. Some of the thrillers I can kind of handle, but
you need someone to cuddle with.
I do. You're right. Maybe then I'll feel safer and I won't be so scared. Thank you.
And then sometimes I go to your website and I binge watch on Jennifer Day TV.
Ah, yay! Well, that's my favorite one. Points. That's awesome. Yay. Well, thank you so much for calling, Michael. Did you have a song request today?
Yeah, I'd like to hear Human. I haven't heard you do Human for a while.
I would love to sing that. Thank you for asking. Okay, well, I will talk to you next week.
Okay.
Okay, bye, Michael.
Bye-bye.
Hello, you're on Live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Hi, Jennifer.
Hey, Betty. How's John and Matthew and all the party people over there?
Oh, we're fine. We're all doing good.
Oh, that's good. So tell me about a TV show that you guys are watching lately that you really like.
Well,
maybe right before you were watching me.
Oh, well, once we watched was, I used to watch Leverage.
Oh, I love that show. That's a good show.
You like that one?
Yeah. It's cool
and
to see how they put all the pieces together, and then they kind of go after the bad guy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what else? Uh-huh.
Yeah. I watched some... like the Game of Thrones.
Oh, you're a Game of Thrones girl. That's cool. I've seen everything up until this weekend. I know they just did the premiere release of this new season on Sunday. Don't give me any spoilers. I didn't get to watch it yet, so I have it on my TiVo. So I'm going to watch it later this week. But that's cool. I like that show, too.
Yeah, I've seen that. There was another one, and I can't think of the name of it, but it had a lot to do with the Romans and them.
Was it on HBO a long time ago? Was it called Rome?
Uh-huh.
Because I watched a show like that, and it was called Rome. Yeah?
Yeah, you're right.
Yes, that's the one. Yeah, that was a binge-worthy show.
Yeah, that was one we had to watch. All right.
Yeah.
It's called Rome.
Yeah, it's kind of in that Game of Thrones world where it was like very intense drama all the time. But you were so wrapped up in the story, you were just like, you couldn't stop watching it. Yeah, and this was before, like, the days of Netflix and stuff, so you kind of had to wait to the next week. And even HBO now, you still have to wait till the next week. They only put, like, one episode out until the whole season's done, and then you can binge the whole thing. But, yeah, that's a good show. Good one.
You know, there's some they have on, like we were watching, which they're taking it off the air. It's got one letter. It's called Rookies.
Oh, the show. I watch Rookie about the cop that's a little older.
Yeah, it's got one last showing coming up, and that's it.
And they're not doing another season?
No.
Aw, well, that's too bad, because that's Nathan Finnegan. That's a really good show. I watched that show, too. I'm sad. You know, he did a show that I really liked that's very binge-worthy called Castle. Have you seen Castle?
Oh, I watched that. Yeah.
Yeah, that was a good show.
Too.
I like those mystery shows, you know, detective dramas. Those are always really fun. I watch Law & Order SVU. That's a good one, too. And then, yeah, I'm surprised they're not going to bring Rookie back, but, you know, he'll find something else because he's a good actor.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
You know what I used to watch with my daughter? Aww. I used to watch Buffy the Vampire Slayer with my daughter.
Yes, yes. You know, I don't think I ever watched that one. I didn't get into the vampire thing, but I did like her, Sarah Michelle Gellar. She did a couple, like, cool movies. I liked her. And they have another one, True Blood, with vampires. If you like that kind of thing.
Oh, wait a minute. Isn't that the one where they have guys that turn into wolves?
Maybe. I didn't watch that. It was a little scary for me. So I'm kind of a baby.
No, there's one like that. I went to the movies. The theater and watched it with my daughters. It was awesome.
Oh, that's cool. You know, there's a movie that I'm attached to that they haven't made yet. So sometimes in the movie industry, what will happen is there'll be producers and a script and a bunch of people that get together that want to shoot a movie. And then they get the funding together and then they have, you know, actors attached to it. And it was Tom Hardy that was going to play the lead. And then I was going to play a supporting role in it. And so this movie is called Hidden Valley. And so then sometimes a year will go by and you're wondering, like, are they going to make this movie? What's happening? So you just kind of stay attached to it. So I'm still waiting to find out what's going on with that. And I know that they were waiting to find out about Tom Hardy's availability because he's doing so many things right now. So that might be what we're waiting on. But anyways, that movie is about people who turn into werewolves. And one of the executive producers is somebody who raises wolves. So remember we were talking about the sanctuary last week? So she actually has a big farm,
right,
property that she raises wolves. So she's got tons of wolves that she was going to have, you know, be a part of this film. I didn't get to meet one. My agent did. But apparently it was so cool to actually meet these wolves, you know. And they were just very kind and, you know, they were very tame and trained. So, I mean, of course, you know, you want the trainer to be there, right? You don't want to go out in the wild with them. But it was a really cool kind of concept. So anyways, hopefully that movie will happen and then I'll get to be part of a werewolf movie. Yay!
Well, you know, what I've heard is that for a wolf to actually attack a person, they're more frightened and they'll run. They'd have to be really, really hungry before they'd eat a person.
Right.
But majority, they'll keep away.
Right, yeah, yeah. Well, I would love to eventually meet one someday. So what a cool experience to have it be a part of a movie. So.
Yeah, I want to do that too. I really do.
Yes.
Jennifer,
yeah.
What is your favorite kind of movie? Thriller, like cops or mystery?
Comedy.
Scary. What's your favorite?
Comedy, all the way.
okay.
Yeah, those are my favorite. I love to laugh. I love sitcoms, all that stuff. One of my favorite TV sitcoms is The Big Bang Theory. I love that show. It's super funny. And then they have another one lately that my favorite like comedy of all time is Will and Grace. That's such a hilarious show, and they brought that back, which made me super happy. So I've been watching that one every time too, for sure.
They have it. I can't think of the name of it now. It's coming out, I think, this coming week. But it's where this couple move into the country, and they have no idea about a farm. And they have the farm, but this cow is coming toward her, and she's running up.
Yes! I've seen that.
It's going to be funny, so I can't wait to start watching.
Yes, it's called Bless This Mess. Bless This Mess, if you're looking for it.
Okay, you're right. All right.
Well, thank you so much for calling, Betty. I'm going to try and say hi to a few more people, but I'll talk to you again next week, okay?
All righty. Yeah, and I got that. Stuff will be coming in the mail to you.
Yay! Okay, good. I'll be looking for it. Thank you.
Love you.
Bye. Bye-bye. I love you too. Bye. Hi, you're on Live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Oh, it's going good, Jennifer. How are you?
I'm good. This must be Joe from Jersey, a.k.a. All Around the World, traveling man.
Yeah, I'm home for the weekend. I'm taking it easy. Yes.
Nice. Yes, you finally get to put your feet up and watch some TV. So what are you watching?
Well, I watched Game of Thrones last night, of course. I didn't miss that. I did a binge before that. I took the last years, and I was sort of laid up over the weekend, so I watched the last years to get psyched up for the new episodes.
Oh, so you had a very binge weekend.
And that way I behaved myself for the weekend.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you are like
I sort of got into
Game of Thrones crazed right now.
Yes. Yeah, and it was good. So when you get to, we won't talk about it until you
yes, no spoilers.
Get a chance to actually see it.
Thank you.
No spoilers, I promise.
Yes, I remember when I first started watching Game of Thrones, I was auditioning for a play, actually. It was a musical. And there's a character on there, Sansa. And so they had me up for this role. And so the audition was like in 3 days or something. And I had to put a song together. And usually, you know, you just kind of go to the audition with whatever they give you. But Game of Thrones is such a big deal. I was like, you know what? I really need to watch this show before I go because I'm going to be completely clueless. And they're going to think I'm crazy for never watching this show. So I said, well, let me just watch the first episode, maybe the second episode. I watched the entire first series by the time I went to that first season before I went to that audition. Oh my gosh, I could not stop. Yeah. And then I started realizing this is not a show you can watch before you go to bed. Nope. Because
no.
Then I was not sleeping. It was crazy. My brain was just kind of kept picturing all of these things. And I mean, it's such an intense show that, you know, like you really, you kind of need a palate cleanser afterwards. It's so great, but I would need to watch like I Love Lucy or something before I went to bed to like just kind of get my head out of you know Winterville or Winterfell. That's the one.
Yeah, the other thing about that show is that you really don't want to fall in love with any of the characters because you never know who's going to disappear.
I know.
At a moment's notice. Yeah.
I know. They shocked you with that.
Yeah, the first time I watched the first season, and I thought, they can't possibly kill this guy off. He's the king. He's, you know, he's the king of the north. He's going to be there. And all of a sudden, bam, there goes his head.
Oh, my gosh. Well, if you guys haven't seen the first season, that was a spoiler. But I guess shame on you if you haven't seen the first season yet, because they're in, like, what, seven?
Yeah. If you're not going to watch it by then. And there's a lot of other stuff that happens anyway.
Yeah, too. You'll still get into it. Don't worry. But it is a show that you have to watch from the beginning. Like, you can't just come in on the sixth season and then figure it out. You're going to be so lost.
No.
So that's but I will say, have some time because you're going to watch at least 3 hours the first time you watch it. You're not going to want to stop, right?
Yeah. Yeah, and that's the good thing about watching that kind of a show is when you can do a binge because it really is. It's better than TV because it just goes on and on and on and on, and it gets deeper and deeper. I sort of got into it. First real binges, I think, was I heard about The Sopranos. I never thought I would like it. And then I turned it on, and I went out and started buying seasons of the CDs so I could watch them all in a row, because you couldn't get them at that time much on TV. So it cost me a fortune in CDs, DVDs, to watch The Sopranos.
I know, and they're just sitting in the corner now, doing nothing, right? Collecting dust.
Yes. Yeah, well, they were my people. I just, all these people.
That's right, you Jersey boys out there.
I thought, oh my God, that's just look like Uncle Tony, and that's Uncle Frank. And, it was really funny.
Yes, and you always wonder why there were some things that they just didn't talk about in front of the family.
Yes.
Is there really a Bada Bing club out there?
Yeah, there is. There is?
There is?
There is. In fact, I have a signed picture from Tony Soprano.
That is cool.
In fact, I saw him once in a play. Actually, when I was in your neighborhood once, I saw a play. It was really good.
Yeah.
And really kind of surprising.
I saw him in a play too. So it might be the same
Did
one.
You?
What was the play called?
Oh boy, I won't remember the name. All I remember is somebody threw up in the play.
Oh my goodness.
you remember that part of the play?
I think so. It wasn't the highlight for me. But no, I remember seeing him in a play, and he was very, very good. So I can't, and they made a movie out of it too, but I can't think of the name of it either.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, we'll have to come back to that one.
I'll have to look up the name. The other ones that I liked in the past, I spent some time watching, what was it called? Oh, I was pretty religious with Homeland. So I sort of got into that. And just
who's the lead girl in that, Homeland?
I won't remember.
You know, she was Juliet in the Romeo and Juliet movie with Leo. Oh, goodness. Yeah. I can't think of her name. I got to meet her at the People's Choice Awards. And she was very nice, but she was super quiet. So I guess, you know, she in her personal life, she's very quiet too. So I mean, in that show, she's very dramatic. But yeah.
Yes.
It was nice to meet her though. She was very chill.
Yeah, so I got hooked on that one. And another one I liked was, what was it called? Oh, it was called Strange Science.
Oh, well, that was a long time ago, right? Oh, no, that was Weird Science.
Was it Weird Science? Maybe it was Weird Science.
Wasn't it with, like, two young kids and they, like, created their own woman out of the computer? Is that the show?
No.
That's different. Okay.
This one was different. It was about really a guy who was a serious scientist, and then there was two parallel worlds that they lived in. I think that was the name of it. I'll have to look that up. I was just thinking about
it. Speaking of science shows, the first show I think I ever binged was Cosmos.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Such a great show. If any of you guys are interested in astronomy or learning about the planet, the universe, all of that stuff, like, it's fascinating. And I watched that. Like, I think in maybe 2 weeks, I watched it twice. Like, it was so good. I was just like, I can't get enough of this. So now I really am interested in a lot of science shows, science documentaries about space travel and all these things. And like life on, you know, on other planets, possibly, you know, stuff like that. But more documentary where it's very scientific and, you know, interesting like that. So, yeah. I got into those.
Yeah, I actually used that. I used that whole series. I taught astronomy for a few years back, and I actually used that. I tried to make the course more interesting for the students, and so integrated that into the course. And the people really seem to enjoy it. So, they're supposed to make another one.
Oh, that'd be cool.
There's lots of stuff that's been going on lately, so I'm looking.
Well, I know they had the original with Carl Sagan. I think back in the 80s. And then they used his, you know, a lot of his script and his findings for the new one with Neil deGrasse Tyson as the host. And hopefully they'll do another season of it, because that would be very cool. And they use, you know, of course, now the graphics are spectacular. All the artwork that they use is very, like, you know, eye-catching. They keep you engaged the whole time. It's very cool. And then the history that they teach, it actually doesn't feel like you're, you know, in class. It's just an interesting show. It's like you're part of, watching this story unfold. You know, it's very cool.
that was the idea, and seemed to work it really in class too. So it was an interesting experience trying to integrate the two.
Nice. Wow.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, so I've gotten into the, every once in a while, getting really sucked into a show like that. But I really like it if I can watch a whole bunch of them to catch up. I've done that a couple times where the new season was going to start and I wanted to catch up by that. So I had like 3 years of it.
Yes. Definitely. Well, thank you so much for calling. Did you have a song request today?
Yeah, I'm trying to remember the name of the song. It's called Jump Back, or it was.
Yes.
I always call it the Pussycat song.
Ah,
is
yes.
Is that the one?
Meow.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. It's actually called He Jumped Back.
I look forward to you doing your little bit on the floor. That you do.
Oh, my. You remember that.
Yes. Yes, I do. It sticks in my mind quite a bit. Yeah.
Fun.
All right, Jen. Really good talking to you.
Thank you. Thank you for calling.
Okay.
Okay, bye. Bye, Joe.
Bye.
All right, you guys. I wanted to do a thank you for some donations that you guys have been giving. So I really appreciate it. And so for you guys who are watching for the first time, you can actually call me right now. All you need to do is click on the little link below or above the video if you're on Facebook. It's streamlabs.com/JenniferDadeTV. Or you just click on, if you're on my website, click here to donate. And then once you donate either $5 or more, I appreciate, then you're going to get an email receipt from PayPal. And in that is a phone number underneath my name. And that's how you call me. So if you want to call me today or next week, you can donate now and then save it for next week. And, get up a little more courage and call me. I'm very nice, so you can call and say hi. Be nice back. I want to say thank you for another donation. Thank you very much. Okay, so I had some requests for some special songs. So this was a request by Michael. He wanted to hear me sing Human. So let me... As soon as my tablet doesn't freeze on me, these technical things sometimes. Okay. Water on my lips. Michael. Thank you so much for that request. And I want to do another thank you for a donation. I